Okay, so you know how to use Google Advanced Search and you would like a way to search without having to go to the Google Advanced Search screen. Well, a lot of the features in Google Advanced Search you can type in to get the same results just from the Google Search screen. So the most basic would be searching for a phrase to make sure the phrase is all together. So that way we would use the quotation marks, global warming. So we're just searching for those two words right together. It has to come up. Those quotation marks force it to just be together. That's like when you're searching in the advanced search screen and it says this exact phrase. Well, you can do that just with quotation marks. Let's say you only want to look at web pages with global warming in the title of the page instead of just anywhere. What you would do before your phrase, whether it's quotation marks or whether it's not with quotation marks, doesn't matter. All in title, colon. So you type in all in title, colon, before whatever you're searching for, whether it's a phrase or whether it's just one word. Now, if you see this comeback, take this as a big compliment. You have triggered Google to be suspicious of you because you're now searching in a very sophisticated manner that the average person does not know how to do this kind of searching. And they think that you're a robot or something. So, don't get scared. I've been doing this kind of searching. This is the only way I search the internet. I've been doing it like this way for about 10 years. No one has ever come and gotten me. So, just type that in. Okay, so I proved I'm a human. Now, global warming is in the titles of all of the websites. Well, that's good, but there's so many different kinds of websites here. Let's say I only want to look at US government websites. So I could type in site colon dot gov. Government websites. Now everything, and notice our search result totals are really going down here. We started out with millions, now we're down to thousands. Now everything is coming from some type of a government organization here. A lot from NASA here, NCDC, all sorts of different government organizations. Okay? And that's good. But here, oh, climate change. Well, maybe we're missing out on some websites by not searching for climate change as well. So here's how you do that. We're going to still be in all in title, global warming or quotation marks, climate change. And from my experience, it does have to be in all caps, the or. It tends to work better if you put it in all caps, that connector. Okay? So still all in title, global warming or climate change. Have to be in the title. Still has to come from some kind of a government website. Okay? 44,300. So that increased it quite a bit. We had about 3,500 otherwise. So now you notice global warming is not in the title of this one, but climate change is. That's what we were searching for, global warming or climate change. Now they could both be in the title, that's fine, but we wanted websites or web pages that had just those in there. Now that's really cool. Let's say we want to make it even more specific. So we're looking for global warming or climate change in the title. Site has to come from some kind of government website. What about the file type? We're looking at all kinds of web pages here. Let's say we're looking for PDFs. Now, if it's a PDF, chances are it's a professional article or a government report or something that was designed to be published in print that was later stored online. So, how about file type? So, this is file type, colon, and PDF. Okay, now everything that comes back is a PDF, which are nice for citing because usually they're going to have page numbers. They're easy to save, they're easy to download to your computer, and they're very easy to print out. And they're generally very heavy on the facts and the breakdowns because they were designed to be handouts or reports or articles. Okay? Let's say we wanted a different type of format. That's a PDF. What about a PowerPoint? What about are there any government PowerPoints stored online? File type PPT. Okay. Now all of these would be PowerPoint presentations that you could watch or download to your computer. Pretty cool stuff, and you can do all of this from the search box. Now let's take this back a little bit. Let's say you wanted to search for websites or web pages with global warming and climate change in the titles, only from government websites. So instead of or, what if I wanted both of those in there? By default, if you just put those in next to each other, it will search for those as an and. You don't have to type in and. Okay, and I'm getting my little thing here again. They're saying, gee, how come you know how to search the internet so well? You should take this as a compliment if you get this little page. Okay? Now you notice we have climate change and global warming in all the titles of the pages, and they're all from government websites. So, pretty cool stuff. Let's try something a little different type of a search. Let's say we're looking for things from educational websites. So, all in title, Telltale Heart, the famous story by Edgar Allan Poe. So I want web pages that have Telltale Heart in the title, and I want them, instead of from government websites, I want them to come from some kind of educational institution, site.edu. Okay? Now all of these have Telltale Heart in the title, and they're all coming from some type of an educational institution. Now, it might be nice to look at the PDFs here, because if they're PDFs, probably they're going to be articles. Cite PDF. Oh, it didn't like that. Let's try. Oh, you know what? I needed to do file type. Whoops, my mistake. File type. But we're looking for the type of file. That makes sense. File type colon PDF. Yay! Now, these are all PDFs, and you'll probably find a lot of articles in here. Pretty cool stuff. Okay, let's talk about .orgs. So we can go back to our earlier search here, global warming site.org. So a .org is a nonprofit. So global warming has to be in the title, and the site has to be some type of a nonprofit. And that's great. We found a lot of good things here. Now, a lot of times, for your classes, they're not going to want to see you using Wikipedia sources. So if that's the case, what you could do after this is type in a minus sign, minus Wikipedia. Uh-oh, we got our little thing again. It's really getting suspicious of me. Again, take this as a compliment. Uh-oh, I must have typed it wrong. Okay, there we go. Now we're seeing global warming in the title from .orgs, and I'm not seeing Wikipedia in there. Okay, well, this is all good stuff. Let's say you wanted to do global warming in more than one type of site. Let's say we want to look at global warming in .gov or .edu. So we want to look at government websites or websites, web pages published by educational institutions. Okay, now we've got .gov, 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 and if we look, we keep looking down here, we get some .edus as well, .edus. So now we're getting things published by educational institutions and government agencies. Again, I always capitalize, put it in all caps, that or, it seems to work better. How about we also want .org in there? Okay, now we're doing .orgs, .edus, and .govs. And if we wanted to, we could take out the Wikipedia sites as well. So if we don't want Wikipedia, we could just minus that out. Okay, pretty interesting stuff here too. Now you could also get even more specific than this. Let's say you could search within a specific website and use a website sort of as a kind of like a database. So let's say site. Now we want to get more specific than just government websites. How about the Environmental Protection Agency website? Because that's a huge website that we could use as a database. So all in title, global warming, and it has to be from the EPA. Site, epa.gov. Oh boy, why are you searching this way? How come you know how to search the internet the right way? Submit. Okay. Now you have 362, and that's good because I don't want a ton of results. And look, global warming, that phrase, and they're all coming from the EPA. So everything in there is coming from the EPA. And maybe, I don't know, let's see if they have any PDFs. Okay, they just had one in there, but I'm searching a lot less. And this is probably a pretty good PDF. Frequently asked questions about global warming and climate change. Again, it was designed as some kind of a brochure or a handout or a report. So it's going to be heavy on the facts. Okay? And you could also do, everything doesn't have to be like this. Let's say you want to look at all in the title, election, and you want to look at a certain newspaper site, dailycamera.com for the Boulder Daily Camera, the newspaper in Boulder, Colorado. Okay? So now all of these are going to be news stories published in the Boulder Daily Camera, at least from their website, that all have election in the title. Pretty interesting stuff. Maybe we want election and Colorado. So all in title, election, Colorado, site, dailycamera.com, 37. Pretty good. Pretty good. So this gives you a lot of different ways you can search just using the search box. You could also, let's say, all in title, Iron Maiden and Eddie, site, YouTube.com. So we're looking for videos on YouTube that feature Iron Maiden, the rock band Iron Maiden, and their mascot, Eddie. So now we have all these videos of Iron Maiden's mascot, Eddie. So you can search any way you want. It just gives you a lot more control over Google, and you can do all of this from this box here instead of having to go to Google Advanced Search. Okay, hopefully that made sense to you. Let me know if you have any questions.